Hey guys, welcome back to Take Up Tarot. And before I start this video, I just want to share a really, really cool story with you. So this morning when I went to take a walk in the park that is right opposite my house, I usually go there in the mornings and it's just the way I like to start my day. And what happened was I reached a bench close to, you know, the place where I usually sit, and I found a book. This one. Now, usually the part of that community that I am in, this is something that happens very frequently. So if you don't need a book, you place it and somebody picks it up. So that is just the community that we have. And this is the book that I found. And I just feel like this is the book that I needed, because I have spent the last couple of days just taking some time to myself and really relaxing, because I did face a little bit of burnout and, you know, just to refresh myself. And I found this book, and the message that I found in the morning was just perfect for me to start the day. And so I thought, I need this book, and I took this book with me. And what am I going to do today is I'm going to use one little part of it, because this has like little stories, you know, just a little bit of it. And I think this is a part of the Bible. Forgive me, I'm not a Christian, but it's just, you know, beautiful messages. And whether you are a Christian or not, we could all use a little bit of wisdom. So I'm going to treat this like a little bit of an oracle. So that's what we are going to be doing today additionally. So now, coming back to the usual video, we are talking about the week ahead. And yes, as usual, you have three piles in front of you, and you can pick out whichever one that speaks to you the most. You can pick out according to the beautiful feathers or just the pictures. Now, this is a new deck. This is the Everyday Witch Oracle, and I'm really excited about it. I'm going to do a full walkthrough with it as well. But anyway, I'm not going to chat any further, and I'm just going to let you pick your card, and then we will start off with the very first pile, which is pile one. Okay, pile one. Let us see what the week ahead has in store for you. Now, I'm just going to be placing the cards up here first so that, you know, we can just see them more clearly, and then we shall go on to the entire message. And from your tarot cards, we have the Queen of Cups, one of my absolute, absolute favorite queens. Next, you have the Hanged Man. Next, you have Judgment. Very interesting. You have two major arcanas. From your flower oracle, we have lavender. Okay. The next one is chrysanthemum. All right. From the romance angels, we have playfulness. And I have two more, which I'm going to be taking later, because I think we are pretty full here. Okay, now we shall start off with your tarot cards first. Now, the very first that you have here, I'll start off with the Hanged Man. Is the Hanged Man is about looking at things from a different perspective. So possibly as you go into this week, you are encouraged to look at certain things with a fresh set of eyes. You know, really, really look at them clearly, because sometimes what happens is, you know, things are right in front of our eyes, but we cannot see them. So, you know, the Hanged Man is also about taking that little bit of pause, because as you can see here, this Hanged Man is like, you know, suspended from a tree. So this is like that moment of stillness, that moment of calm, where you see things clearly and then decide what the right next move is. So that is exactly what I have here. But this also, for a couple of people, can also be the calm after the storm. So possibly this is like that little bit of breather coming in for you. Whatever it is, you are now looking at things clearly and from a different perspective. Also, what happens as a result of this Hanged Man is you are moving into a different direction. So last week, for one pile, you had the Death card, and now we have Judgment, which is the rebirth. And it really makes a lot of sense, you know, for you guys. It's like you're heading into a new direction. You are taking in a new direction. Possibly now, because you're seeing certain things clearly, that is sort of, you know, sending you out in a new direction. But whatever it is, you are going to be doing things in a new way, possibly in your own unique way, is what I see here. And again, with the Queen of Cups here, this is all about using your intuition. This is all about using your inner guidance and that really creative aspect of yourself. This is like, you know, she's the Queen of Emotions. So possibly, you know, using your emotions, using your intuition to help you sort of make those decisions. So when you are suspended like the Hanged Man, in this coming week, maybe use your intuition a little bit, and maybe that is now going to help you to sort of take that next step in your coming week. All right, now next what we'll do is we will just take your Moonology card, and that again speaks about, you know, stepping out of your comfort zone. So you are very much now moving out of your comfort zone, and that again is supported by transformation and change and having faith. So you are going to be making a lot of changes in your life, in your romance, in your relationships, or when it comes to your work. But there is a need for you to sort of, you know, make those changes. And I see these changes being really good for you, because these changes are something that you're taking intuitively. You're taking those decisions using your inner guidance. And whenever you make decisions on the basis of your inner guidance, they are always helping you go towards the right track. And you know, there is a need to not be afraid anymore. You have to take that leap of faith towards the direction which is now calling to you. Just take that leap of faith, you know. You have to also move outside your comfort zone. You know, comfort zone is not a place out of which great things come. And you know, on our channel, we are all about this growth. We are all about moving out of our comfort zones and really, really working towards a life that speaks to us. Really working towards a life that really calls out to us. And that is exactly what you're meant to do now. So step out of that comfort zone. Do something that you've not done before. So for you this week, I think it's all going to be about, you know, being a little bit brave and taking that next step in faith. All right, but this could also be like you have been in a suspended motion for quite some time, and I feel like this change, this transformation is very much coming, and you sense it intuitively. I believe that this needs to happen now. It's like you're facing your truths, because you know what is really, really special about this card is you have this cat facing another cat. And this one cat has this beautiful, you know, butterfly on her feather, and this other cat, it's almost like on the way, is getting there. So this is like this cat is greeting her towards those changes, and you have another butterfly flying in. So this change is going to be welcome. This transformation is going to be welcome. And if you look at this card very closely, the lady who's proceeding towards this change is doing that with a smile on her face. She doesn't really seem, you know, like any less confident. So that is the message to you. As you move out of your comfort zone, as you move towards this life, possibly a new life or a new way of living, you are asked to proceed with a lot of confidence, because you definitely have what it takes to make those changes and to now invite into your vortex whatever it is that you want to happen. This is almost like taking that first step with a lot of faith. And knowing that whatever is going to come out of it is going to come out of it beautifully. And it's going to be for your highest good. Okay, that is the message that I'm getting here from this card. Also, what I'm getting here is with lavender. So there is a need to cleanse. There is a need to cleanse your emotions. There is also a need to cleanse from any negativity, anything that is holding you back. This could also be that decluttering is what I'm getting here. Or just working with your emotions, really processing them, because you have the Hanged Man here, you know, you are taking that little bit of space, and in that space, decide what it is that you need to let go, or what it is that you want to carry with you in your next journey is what I'm getting here. But this also speaks to me about saging, you know. Of course, you can use lavender, but again, you know, saging is a process that really, really helps you cleanse your surroundings, that even helps you cleanse yourself. So that is also something that you can do as you move into this new energy. Also, what I'm getting here is creating a vision board for yourself. about whatever it is that you now want to invite in your life. But your message here is be here always with willing hands and heart. So as you move forward, you may be, you know, of course, asked to move ahead in your comfort zone, move beyond your comfort zone. So now, you know, you might come across a lot of things that you've not done before. So then the message for you here is, as you move forward, do that with willingness. And willingness not only in your heart, but also with your hands. So whatever it is that needs to be done, needs to be done. And be willing towards it. Your willingness is the key here. Your intention is the key here. Your faith is the key here, is what I'm getting. Now moving ahead with our romance angels, we have the playfulness card. So when it comes to your romance, when it comes to your relationship, there is a need to be a little bit playful this week. You know, especially in established relationships, you need to be a little bit playful. You need to have that fun aspect to yourself. No matter how long you've been married, no matter how long you've been together. Like just that youthful energy, that energy of, you know, how things were when you met the first time, that is something that your relationship needs. And even if you're single, you need to put yourself out there, you know, and you need to make this process into something that is fun. Okay, don't make this like something that you're dreading. All right. The energy has to be amazing. Possibly this for you when it comes to your reading could also be transforming your energy and making it a little bit playful. Really enjoying life, enjoying the process of finding your soulmate, finding that partner, you know, in your relationship. That is also something that I'm getting. And along with that, you have laughter. So this for you, according to your relationships or for people, this is, you know, introducing laughter into your relationship. Just watching a funny movie together. And just really, you know, even just that playfulness, you know, just laugh with your partner. Connect, you know, as if you were like, you know, this could be like, you know, treating your relationship or romance like something straight out of a high school musical is what I'm getting here. Laugh, bring that joyful energy, bring that playful energy to your relationships, because that is especially important for you, especially because you have the Queen of Cups. This is about that flowing of emotions, an easy flowing of emotions, okay? And this could also be, you know, taking your relationship into a different direction, like letting go of the negativity of whatever it is, or just that relationships sometimes tend to settle down. You need to get rid of that. Okay, and the last one that we have here is listening. So this could actually be connecting with your partner, listening to what they have to say, exchanging stories, or just listening to each other and just connecting with each other and being playful about it. Bring that fun aspect back to your relationships is what we have for this week. All right. So these are your messages for your upcoming week. A lot of beautiful changes happening in for you. And I see all of them being very, very positive. And because I totally forgot that I was also supposed to read you a little bit from the book. Here we are. So we're just going to randomly choose a page. Okay. Oh, you'll never walk alone. If you're struggling on your own to face the challenges, then you need to know that you're not alone. The God of all comfort is with you. And this is very, very interesting because, you know, the card that we had here was this, walking towards something. So this is like a confirmation for me. And I don't know if you believe in this, but this is like, you know, as you head towards this transformation and change, you are not alone. And as you move out of your comfort zone, you are not alone. So God, universe, spirit, your spirit guide, angels, whatever it is that you choose to believe in, they are with you. I love this. I absolutely love this. And I knew this book was magical. And please come back at the end of this week and let me know how things worked out for you, what came true and what this transformation was. Because I'd really, really like to know. I will see you once again in my next video and next week, of course, with your weekly readings. Bye-bye. Hello, my beautiful pile twos. And if you've chosen this one, let us see what is it that is in store for you for the coming week. Now you have strength and resilience. Very interesting. Next you have focus from the Moonology deck. You're very close to achieving your goal. Okay. From your tarot cards, you have Chariot, you have Justice, and you have the Two of Cups. Okay. And from your romance angels, you have Wedding, which is extremely interesting again. The next one is Cornflower and Gladioli. And we also have two more cards, which I'm going to be taking later. All right. Now, starting off with the very first card, we shall start off with the Chariot. So the Chariot is all about, you know, choosing which way to go, because obviously, you know, you if you see this card, you have like two ways in which you can go. You can go this way and that way, but the way in which you are supposed to head should always be your way. So this week you need to sort of take the control of your life in your hand and really decide which direction you want your motorcycle to go in. All right, so put yourself at the helm of affairs and make that conscious decision. But also, because your next card is Justice, this could also be about doing something right. All right. So whatever decision you take, make sure you're taking a decision that sits right with you, that sits right with your soul, and that is the right decision for your life. So I think you really need to weigh things very clearly and then make a decision as to what fits you. Okay, but for a couple of people, this could also be finding that balance in your life, because I always give this message out. And this could also be like things finally becoming fair, or you getting your due is also what I'm getting here. Okay, coming to the next one, we have the Two of Cups. Now, Two of Cups is such a beautiful energy. This is all about connecting. You really have those emotions flowing here. So this could also be you potentially meeting somebody that you could, you know, really connect with. Now, this doesn't always have to be a meeting that happens physically. This could also be a meeting somebody online, or just connecting with somebody on a deeper level. But again, another message that I have out here is also a business partnership. So really entering into a partnership with a person, but I just feel like this partnership is going to be just right. And then this could also be you signing some contracts this month. All right. But whatever it is, this will feel right to you. And I think the decision that needs to be taken has to sit right with you, not only practically, but also emotionally, is what I'm getting here. Okay, so it's definitely going to be very important, because you have two major arcanas for you. So this decision can be really important, not only for today, but also for long time in the future. Another card that we have here is Focus. So you really need to make sure that your focus is on the right things this week. Now, because we also have, you know, this could be like a work related contract, or because, you know, you're probably choosing what place to work with, or you're just getting that new job offer and you're signing documents relating to it, you need to really make sure that you have the fine print in place, that you're really reading everything, and then you're making a decision based on a balanced point of view. Okay. Also, you need to really make sure that the things that you're signing, whether they are in your favor or not. All right. Whatever partnership also it is that you're entering, even if this is a romantic relationship, you need to ensure that, you know, it's a balanced relationship where the give and take is equal. So you really need to be in the hot seat. You need to be in the driver's seat of your life for this week, because whatever choices you're making, you have to be very focused, and you have to make that right choice for yourself. Okay. Also, what I'm getting for you is, because of this card, you have strength and resilience. So you really have what it takes to move forward. You have what it takes to take those decisions. You have what it takes to really move forward with things. Okay. And you know, your position this week is one of a lot of strength. So whatever decision that you're taking, you have to make the decision as a boss. because the control is in your hands, you know. Just look at this card. I absolutely love this deck because this, witch has a wand in her hand and she is sort of making that storm happen. So that's exactly the case with you. You have to be in the driver's seat, and you are in the driver's seat. I don't know whether you realize it or not, because that's exactly the point here. You need to realize certain things about yourself. And you just are the kind of person who is very resilient, and you're very strong, and you're very capable, and you deserve a lot, is something you need to remember this week. So there are a lot of things that you could make happen this week. Okay, so make sure you're taking that control in your hand and you're being very, very focused about things. Also, another message out here is setting boundaries for good growth. So whatever decisions you're taking, whatever you're moving towards this week, you need to also set some boundaries. Because without boundaries, without putting yourself first, you cannot ensure your own growth. And that's very important for all of us, isn't it? So put yourself first is also another message that I have to give out here. Alright, the next one that I have here is learn from friendships old and new. So there is obviously something that you need to learn. Or what I'm really getting here is from your past relationships is also something that I'm getting. Like you need to learn certain lessons from your past and ensure that you're not repeating it again. And this not only has to do with your relationships, but a lot of aspects in your life. Possibly there have been instances where you've not been good with boundaries. There have been instances where you've not put yourself first, but you need to correct that. The balance has to now tip more in your favor is what I'm getting. All right. So make sure you're also getting what you give is what I have here. All right. And the next one is from the Moonology deck, you're very close to achieving your goal. So whatever it is that you want to achieve, you obviously have a lot of strength. You're very, very capable and you are very close to achieving whatever it is that you want. So you are really in a position of power this week. So whatever decisions you make, make it from that place. All right. Coming to the card of romance, we have wedding. So of course, you know, now there is a possibility that you could have wedding on your mind. Now possibly you are looking at a deeper commitment from the person you're with, or you could just be considering that whether this person that you're dating right now, you have a potential for a marriage or not. For some of you, maybe because you know you could have that Two of Cups, this could also be you connecting really well, but this could also be, you know, you receiving a proposal. Whatever it is, your commitment could be deepening further is what I'm getting here. But for a couple of you, this could also be, you know, thinking about wedding, and this is you thinking about what you deserve now. Because, you know, you also have learned from friendships, old and new. So very much wedding is on your mind. You know, so you are really, really in that place where you're focusing on things. All right. But for a couple of people, of course, this could just be you getting married. In which case, congratulations. And I hope you have a very, very happy married life. Because I already know somebody who's getting married this week. And if she gets that deck, then I'm going to be really, really psyched about it. All right. The next one that we have here is sensuality. So you really, really need to take care of yourself. You need to, you know, focus on yourself. I think the focus here when it comes to your life, when it comes to relationship, is upon you. So take that time to really dress up. Take that time to feel good about yourself. Put that makeup on. Put on those beautiful shoes. And maybe, you know, put that on and then connect with your partner. So deepening of that connection could happen as a result of it. You never know. Because, you know, this could also be just a date night, a very beautiful date night. So this is me giving you an idea, plan a date night, because things could be really interesting for you this week. All right. And what you have next is a perfect match. So for a couple of you, if you are single and you are looking at this potential person, this could be somebody who is a perfect match for you. And probably on certain levels, you realize that and you are looking towards that deeper commitment. Okay, but this could also be you wondering if you're single as to what a perfect match for you is. So this is you thinking about things and really reflecting on what it is that you need to focus on and invite into your life. All right, so very interesting week for you, but I think it's a beautiful week, because any week where you are in control, where you are in the driver's seat, I think it's a fabulous week, isn't it? So I have to remind myself again that I have to give a reading from this one, because I almost forgot with the last pile. Okay, so let us see what we have from the book. Okay, use your secret weapon. Secret prayer is a powerful tool against life conflicts. It provides you with divine ray of light to strengthen and sustain you in dark hours of your life. Okay, so this is really about connecting with God, connecting with spirit, connecting with angels. I think this is very, very significant, because you have a decision coming up. You have that decision, all right? And then I think you need to reflect on what it is that you're making. And if you're somebody who really believes in connecting with your angels, with spirit, with God, this could be something that you need this week. All right, so secret prayer, secret conversations, secret connection is all for you. So before making that big decision, make sure you take that little bit of space to just connect with God and really, you know, seek what you have to seek in prayer. So that will help you strengthen yourself on this beautiful journey. Strengthen yourself further is what I should say. Okay, so this is your message for this week. And let me know if you're enjoying this, okay? Because I always look forward to feedback. And I wish you a fabulous, fabulous week ahead. And I shall see you in my next video, but also for the next weekly predictions video. Till then, bye-bye. Hello, my beautiful pile 3, and let us see what it is that is in store for you for the coming week. So the very first one that we have here is prosperity and abundance. Lovely. The next one is luck is on your side. You guys are on a roll. Next is action. Oh, and what is so interesting is you have two arrows here. Ooh, I love this already. From the romance angels, you have very, very soon. Okay. And from your tarot cards, you have the King of Swords. You have the Hermit. And you have the Eight of Pentacles. Okay. From your flower oracle, you have Hydrangea. Okay. I really need to look this up. Lilac. The next one that you have are these two beautiful cards, which I shall just place here because we are out of space. Right. So the very first card that we have here is the King of Swords. Now the King of Swords is all about using your intelligence and using your ability to sort of take firm decisions. All right. Now the King of Swords is like a very, very direct energy. It is a very clear energy. So any decisions that you take, the way you operate this week has to be with absolute clarity and absolute intelligence. There is no place for emotions here. The decisions you take have to be very, very clear and very, very practical. All right. The next card that we have here is that of Hermit. So Hermit talks about taking that space, you know, taking that little bit of break to connect with yourself, or just this is about isolation. You know, the Hermit is always about isolation. So taking this week out to really sit with yourself to gain some clarity. Now the clarity could be about making decisions, or this isolation that you put yourself under could be so that you could work better. That you could really, really focus on your work. You could focus on honing your skills. That you could focus on gaining that extra knowledge, gaining that extra bit of information about the area that you work with. Okay. This is not really a very social week is what I see for you, because the focus is very inward. Even with a King of Swords energy, you know, he is very knowledge based. He's very intelligence based. So that is the kind of vibe that I get here. This week is all going to be about yourself. It's going to be about connecting with yourself, making your own decisions, getting that clarity. After getting that clarity, implementing those decisions very swiftly and very intelligently, and working on yourself, working on your projects, or just focusing on work is what I have here. All right. Now, the next set of cards that we have here is focus. Okay, focus on wholeness above and below. So again, you know, this week is going to be for you about focusing. So you are really focusing on probably developing yourself or developing an aspect of your life. And I think this for you may be a personal project. This could be a work-related project. But whatever it is, you are really focusing on it and you're giving it everything you have. Because I just sense this clear vision in your mind. Now there is clarity towards whatever it is that you want to do, and you're moving towards it very, very swiftly. So it's a very swift energy and it's a very focused energy for you this week. And what you have is you have luck on your side, you know. So whatever decisions you're taking, whatever you're doing, you just have luck on your side. And especially when you have a card like that, which assures you that luck is on your side, then any actions that need to be taken immediately. Alright, because you also have the action card here. Now this is you moving towards thing very, very rapidly, very, very swiftly, moving very clearly is what I'm getting here. Alright, so it's just very clear, you know, this week is all about swiftness. It's about taking that action with faith, with knowledge, backed with practicality. Alright, the next message that we have here today, the future is sometimes lost in the wanderings of yesterday. So what is necessary is you absolutely need to put the past behind, and possibly that is exactly what you're doing consciously. You are taking that time off, you are sitting with yourself, you're thinking things through, and you're thinking this with clarity. You're doing this to get that aha moment, and I just feel like eventually you get it this week, you know. Because you're just focused, your energy is very much wholesome this week, all right, is what I'm getting here. So because it says that you might sometimes get lost, the focus is also then on to not reflect so much or to not stay in the hermit zone so much that you might get lost in it, all right. If you go into that hermit zone this week, make sure to have certain concrete plans as to what you're going to do with this, you know, zone that you're in, all right. Make sure your focus is on getting solutions and you don't really get trapped in the problem, all right. Now that is just a little warning that we have here. Also, what we have here is this beautiful card. So possibly when you are in this hermit energy, you are also reflecting on your abundance, you're reflecting on how far you've come in life, or you're just being grateful for that abundance. Possibly this is also you enjoying that abundance, something that you worked hard for. All right, this is that little bit of a breather, but make sure to get back to work, you know, because don't really get lost in this energy of abundance and prosperity. You also need to plan for your future. You need to get back to work is also something that I'm getting. So for you, this week is really divided into two phases. One, we're really taking that time off, one to gain clarity, and other to, you know, take that little bit of breather and enjoy that sip of coffee, tea, or whatever your choice of beverage is. And the next one is gaining clarity as a result of this and swiftly moving in towards your future. Coming on to your romance angel, now it says very, very soon. So something that you've been expecting in your life is going to be happening very, very soon. Okay, now this could just be, you know, that connection with your partner, or this could just be you meeting your partner after a long time and you really taking that time to connect with him. But again, this also talking about clearly deciding what it is that you want, so it comes to you very clearly. And isn't this just fabulous? So when you are in that hermit zone, you're also being taken to the direction where you ask that you need to be very, very clear about what you want. So this zone is also going to be very, very related to this zone. All right. So when for single people, if you go into that hermit zone this week, really make sure you are clear on what it is that you want. You need to be the king of swords. You have to be intelligent. You have to be practical. but you have to be clear. All right, so that is the message for you this week. Because what will happen is, as you gain that clarity on what is it that you want, then you will be very, very clear about the action that you need to take. If you have the kind of person that you want decided very clearly in your mind, you can then take that next step about joining a dating app, joining a matrimonial site, or just getting out in the dating zone, you know. And with luck on your side, things can happen very, very soon for you. Okay, so this is all really, really connected, is the sense that I get. So very, very amazing. Again, you have pleasure. So definitely somebody this week is really going to focus on themselves. And you know, we all deserve weeks like that. We all deserve days like that, you know. And if you are called to take that one day for yourself where you just give yourself that break. And you know, what's interesting is this cup here, you know. So really, you are this week going to be taking that time for that much needed self-care, for that much needed, you know, TLC, and give yourself that, and don't even feel guilty about it, okay? Because we all need it and we deserve it, all right? And the next thing is support. So when it comes to people in established relationship, what I get here is possibly your partner could use with a little bit of your support. You know, this could be with regards to their work. This could also be with just everyday life, you know, just little bit of help given to them. You know, this could just be you in your relationship giving your partner that little bit of time to just have that self-care, you know, just to relax. Because you know, we are all going through times when, you know, we are all a little bit on the edge sometimes. And then, you know, having that kind of support, for example, just doing the dishes, trust me, if your partner offers to do dishes for you, that just takes a whole lot from your mind. And you know, possibly giving your partner that opportunity to really enjoy that little bit of breather is also something that I'm getting. So supporting each other in your relationship this week is also going to be very, very crucial. So yeah, focus is on wholeness here, you know, focus is on wholeness. So this is about living your best life, but also planning for the future. It's a beautiful week, I'll say. And with that, we shall come on to your message with regards to God's little book of Calm. And you know, the message for the first two piles have been just so accurate with the cards that I just feel like, you know, this book was meant to be, and it was just meant to come to us. So whoever has sent this my way, I just want to say thank you. Okay, and let us see what your message is. Okay. Slow down. Okay. Don't get caught up in the so-called rat race of life. Next time you go out, purposely slow down or stop if you need to. Let the handiwork of nature declare to you the glory of God. Doesn't this message just personify that card? So yes, definitely, I believe you guys are slowing down a little bit this week. And I just feel like you guys deserve this, you know. Even if that is just for a day. So yeah, I'm going to read it again. Don't get caught up in the so-called rat race of life. Next time you go out, purposely slow down or stop if you need to. Let the handiwork of nature, so maybe spending a little bit of time with nature, declare to you the glory of God. Oh, I love this. I absolutely love this. Okay, so yeah, I think that is the message for you. So the hermit mode is something that is necessary, is what I get here. Okay, take that day off, but also don't forget the rest of the week you have to get back to work, and you are doing that. You are going full proof for it, and you have luck on your side this week. And I shall leave you with that, and I shall see you in my next video. And one thing, don't forget to leave a message about the work, because I really want to hear what you think about it and whether I should include this in my next videos. I shall see you again in my next one. Have a beautiful week. Bye-bye.